Most beef lovers in Taiwan are keen on meat from the US, Australia, New Zealand, and perhaps on the pricey Japanese wagyu. Few know of the indigenous breed of cattle, which is raised here in Taiwan and has a delicious, distinctive flavor. A program to conserve the Taiwan yellow cattle has been underway for 30 years and has brought them back from the brink of extinction. Let's take a look at the local cattle, which are robust and perfectly suited to Taiwan's climate, making their beef leaner and greener than its competitors. Our Sunday special report.
The official ban on wagyu beef imports from Japan was partially lifted recently, causing many Taiwanese gourmands to fall over themselves in their rush to get to the table. Most of Taiwan's beef is imported from countries such as the US, Australia, and New Zealand. Taiwan-raised beef accounts for just 5 to 6% of the market. Many people don't even know Taiwan has its own indigenous beef breed. This is the Hengchun branch of the Livestock Research Institute run by the Council of Agriculture. It's the base of their mission to conserve the Taiwan yellow cattle.
It's our only indigenous breed. It needs to be protected because farmers won't breed them. They dislike how slow they are to mature. So they imported other breeds to mix with the yellows. And over time, the original yellow breed started to disappear. The government spotted the danger, so that's why in 1987, they established the National Livestock Conservation Program.
The Council of Agriculture has carried out this program for 30 years. By allowing yellow cattle to graze and live comfortably in rolling fields like these, and with a lot of hard work, the population of purebred Taiwan yellow cattle has now surpassed 500.
In terms of their appearance, they have quite small and flat ears. And see how their legs are very slim? This is what we call a purebred Taiwan yellow. Everyone tends to think they're really small, but in fact, a mature bull like this one is not small at all, you see? They can grow to weigh 700 kilos. This one is about 600 right now. They're resistant to disease, hot weather, and even ticks, and don't need a special diet. And being small and eating little, they have an advantage in terms of their dietary requirements.
Moving further north from Kunding in Liuijiao Township, Chiayi County, this cattle farmer is also trying to raise the Taiwan yellow cattle in semi-open spaces.
I prefer yellow cattle because they look different to other breeds, see? I think they're like Taiwanese people, as in they're not bothered even by a really hot day like this, like Taiwanese people. However hot it is, the farmers will still go out to the fields, and the cows are really friendly to people. See, when a yellow looks at a person, its eyes are really sharp.
As an indigenous breed, the yellow cattle are emblematic of Taiwan. They may be easy to feed, but they're smaller than other breeds, and they take longer to mature, which makes many farmers hesitate to raise them, fearing for their profit margins. This is one of the reasons why, some years ago, the yellow cattle were on the verge of extinction.
These days, slaughterhouses want to be given bigger cattle because there are lower overheads in slaughtering big cattle, or dealing with big cattle in general.
There's another major challenge in entering the beef market. That's consumers' demands about the quality of the meat.
Okay, say a consumer comes to eat your Taiwan yellow cattle today. You sell it for the same high-end price, but they can't taste the same texture because lean beef has less fat in it. It tastes harder. So when you dip your slice of beef in a hot pot, you just dip it very briefly and then fish it out before it gets too firm.
The yellow cattle's main virtue is its aroma, its flavor. As for its tenderness, well, Taiwanese people rarely eat hunks of beef. We like beef in thin slices or we fry it. If you sear Taiwan yellow beef in a frying pan, it's deliciously tender. It doesn't have a high level of fat in it, so it's relatively good for you.
Scholars believe that it's important to create an officially certified Taiwan yellow beef brand to make it easier for consumers to be sure they're buying the real deal.
It's got to the point where Taiwan yellow cattle need an authority or a body who can award a logo certifying the lineage of the beef and where and how the cattle were raised to tell consumers that it's real Taiwan yellow cattle beef. Otherwise, it's a free-for-all.
The way they advertise the brand is different to how they market something like Aberdeen Angus beef, which is just bred for its delicious taste. We don't have any advantage if we use the same marketing strategies as foreign cattle breeds. So instead, our message is green, low carbon footprint, local and fresh.
There are plenty of well-established brands of beef around the world. Most cattle with high levels of body fat are bred in temperate zones. It might not be possible to breed those brands of succulent beef in subtropical Taiwan. But if more exposure is given to the purebred yellow cattle, with their special place in Taiwan's landscape, perhaps this is where Taiwan will develop its own brand of local beef to be proud of.